is your hour and your season. Look at somebody and say, tonight, heaven must answer you. I didn't hear amen. Look at somebody and say, tonight, heaven must answer you. Look at someone and say, tonight, we will smoke them. And because of the smoke, they cannot stay. They will come out. And as soon as they come out, we will change them with catalysis. Be on your feet and shout. Shout hallelujah. This year, something must happen. Look up to somebody and say, this year, something must what? Must happen. Let me tell you this year, if they don't feel comfortable, they will leave you. Those witches around you, whether wife, whether husband, whether auntie, whether sister, if the fire is too much, let them go. Because when the soup, is hot, no husband can come near. But when the soup becomes cold, you can see green and brown one. Am I right? This same thing is that when you become a pot, those demons cannot come near you. They will draw a line of demarcation. The lukewarm Christian devilizes them. If you don't know. Because you don't disturb him. And if you don't disturb him, he will not disturb you. He likes those people. Lukewarm. So tonight, we are not going to joke. Let's have. May you be seated. May you be seated. The anointing has made me confused. But I give glory to God. Shout hallelujah. Take your Bible. Take your Bible. And just 12 minutes, because I've used 10 minutes for introduction and the whole thing. Just 12 minutes. Let's go through, and after that, we will be on our feet. Shout hallelujah. The book of Esther. The book of Esther. Esther chapter 2. The book of Esther chapter 2. Do you have Esther 2? Esther 2 and verse 19. Esther chapter 2 and verse what? In verse 19. Shout hallelujah. Can I read? Are you there now? When virgins were gathered. Am I reading from the right place? When virgins were what? Gathered together. Am I right? A second time. Mordecai sat within. Am I right? Mordecai sat in what? Within. Shout hallelujah. The king's gates. When the virgins were gathered together a second time, Mordecai sat within the king's what? Gate. Now Esther had not revealed her family and her people, just as Mordecai had charged her. For Esther obeyed the command of Mordecai, as when she was brought up by him. Which means, number one, Esther was a woman of obedience. Amen. Number one, because her own uncle said unto her, do not disclose your identity now. When you disclose your identity now, they can use it against you and you'll be disqualified. Because you are a young captive girl. Do not disclose your identity. You must keep it. And Esther said to the uncle, uncle, I heard you. I will never disclose my identity. Which means Mordecai gave Esther a good advice. Because Mordecai knew some things in the system. He said, Esther, this race, you are very beautiful, but this race, the moment you disclose your identity, they will use it to disqualify you. Which means at times in life, it's not everything that you have to disclose them until the right time. Am I giving the right information? And the word of the Lord said that because of that, Esther restrained and obeyed her what? Her uncle, called what? Mordecai. Shout hallelujah. And in those days, verse 21, and in those days, while Mordecai sat within the king's gate, two of the king's enemies, Bethan and what? Teresh, am I right? The door keepers became furious and sought to lay hands on King Ahasuerus. Two security guys became furious. They conspired against the king. And guess what? When the king has to go out, the king has to pass through the gate. If the king has to come in, the king has to come through the gate. So these doorkeepers to plan against the king showed that the king's life were in what? Danger. They wanted to kill the king. Why? Because jealousy transpired. Shout hallelujah. That is why in life, you always have to be very careful about those who have the spirit of jealousy. Church, treat those who have the spirit of jealousy like Ebola. If you want to go near them, you must wear some armors because they are dangerous. Jealousy will give birth to hatred, and hatred will give birth to murder. If two brothers, Cain and Abel, his own brother called Cain, conspired against him, church, then outsider. Outsider. It will be just 2 minutes. Blood brothers, jealousy transpired. How much more blood sisters? If jealousy transpired among these two brothers, Cain against his brother, how much more an outsider? Shout glory to God. They are very dangerous. And do not disclose your things with somebody who have the spirit of jealousy. Because the more you do that, you put your life in danger. And how can you notice them? At times it will be difficult for you to know them. But what you have to pray to God is that, Lord, may you open my eyes so that I can see them. Because some can come and hold you, but you will not know their motive. Some can say hallelujah, but you will not know their motive. Some can come and say that, brother, I love you, but you don't know their motive. But this 2015, everybody that have evil agenda concerning your life shall leave you. And if they don't leave you, heaven will cause thunder from above, because you are the lost anointed one. If I'm speaking to somebody, shout hallelujah. If I'm speaking to someone, shout glory be to God. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I speaking to somebody? If I'm speaking to someone, shout amen. Church, jealousy can cause somebody to be mad. I am not talking about upset. The person can be mad. Madness, insanity. If you don't know, shout hallelujah. Jealousy can cause somebody to have high blood pressure. Jealousy can cause somebody's pressure to run to, we have nurses here, 120 plus 210. Shout hallelujah. Because the things they don't want to hear about you, they will hear. They will like to hear negative things. But the more they develop negative things, and the more the Lord will bring positive things. So I declare over your life, no matter what they will do, they are not God. Because your destiny is in the hands of God. And whether they like it or not, the more they plan evil things, is the more the Lord will lift the church up. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. If you believe that, shout glory be to God. Shout hallelujah. Church, it happened to Cain, am I right? Cain jealous his own brother. And it happened to Joseph's brothers. So if it happened to Joseph brothers and Cain, it can happen to someone. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. If I were you, I would never jealous anyone. I'll be whom God has made me and be content with what God has done in my life. And mind my business and focus. Because jealousy can kill you before the time. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Church, I am speaking to you right now. As you are hearing right now, sitting under my feet, I declare over your life, because your mind is clean and you have a genuine mind, all their conspiracies will never come to pass. Do you know the reason why? Because your innocence will fight for you. Your innocence will what? Will fight for you. Innocence is a defense about every Christian. And because you are innocent, all their plans will never come to pass. Because they will never find any fault against you. If you believe that song, hallelujah. The time they didn't have, you were there for them. You clothed them. You roofed them. You gave them some things to eat. You did so many things unto them. And at the end of the day, they look at you and say, now, what have you done unto us? May you lift up your eyes unto the hills. Everything you did unto them, at the right time, your God shall reward you. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. May you clap your hands unto Jesus. Look unto somebody and say, this way.
This way.
It's for you today.
Listen
to me. This 2015, jealousy will be rampant. You write it down. The reason why it will be rampant is that you will continue to go higher. And if they will continue to jealous and jealous, at the end of the day, they will go and hang themselves. You will not stop God not to bless you. The more the jealousy, the more the blessings. The word of the Lord said that, and Joseph's five brothers hated him more, and it didn't stop God not to reveal dreams unto Joseph. The more they hated him, the more God increased the dream. Today may you be increased. Shout hallelujah. They don't want to see you holding the hands of your husband. They want to see you always single. And hypocritically, they will come to you and say, now, when are you going to marry? I've been praying for you. When are you going to conceive? So you've not talked all these years. Oh, my sister, church. May the Lord open your eyes and see their mind. Today, I want you to know, the things the Lord is about to do in your life will zip their mouth. Engineer, lift it up for me right now. Shout hallelujah. Look at somebody and say, your God will zip their mouth. If you believe that, shout glory be to God. Shout hallelujah. Look at somebody and say, this year, whether they like it or not, they will hang themselves. Shout hallelujah. They don't want to see you and your husband, but they will see. They don't want to see you pregnant, but they will see. They don't want to see you singing hallelujah, but they will see. They don't want to see the church progressing, but we will progress. They don't want to see the church spreading our tentacles, but we will spread. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. And may you make a joyful noise. Hallelujah. If Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, said that I knew what was in what? Man, that is why I did not put my trust. Hey. Jesus himself. Church, be very careful. Some of you, when you give your heart, you give it full. And when they hit you full. Give 50. And hide 50. And gradually steady. When a person continues to do good, you put another 10, 60. You put another 10, 10. But some of you, 100 right away. And when they hit you, they hit you. Oh, this is my best friend. Oh, this is my key. Oh, you can go. this thing. Your food and everything will be in that your mouth. I prophesy with my eyes open. You are inviting your untimely death. Shout hallelujah. You are inviting your heart untimely death. How come these two men connive against a whole king? And they wanted to lay their hands on what? On him. Hallelujah. Blood hand and what? Perish. A door what? Keep it. Became furious. Am I right? Because they wanted to lay their hands upon what?
The king.
Upon the king. Which means it was easy for them to kill the king. They can pierce the king from the from his own car. Shout hallelujah. Now, let me ask you this. Why they became furious? They received their pay. But why they became furious? Then you know. 22, so the matter became known to Mordecai. The matter became known to who? The matter became known to Mordecai. Who told Queen Esther? Who told what? Look at this, church. Who told Queen Esther? Am I right? The matter became known to who? Mordecai. And told Queen Esther. So which means Queen Esther's uncle was still a security officer. And Queen Esther was in the palace. And if we have to talk well, apart from favor, it's Mordecai who put her there. Because of the advice. How come when Esther received the chance and got into the what? The palace, did not change the position of her uncle. But the uncle was still a security officer. What is that? That will tell you that promotion cometh from above. That will tell you that promotion has something to do with time. Esther did not rush and said that let my uncle continue to stay there. Because when I try something right now, there will be some fishy something. And Esther has every right and to introduce her uncle to the king. And for the king to promote her uncle. But Esther did not. Not knowing that in the timing of God, the Lord knew that there is going to be a time something will happen. So he has to maintain Mordecai still at the gate until the right time. Some people rush themselves and lift themselves up, whereby it's not God who has lifted them. Church, you must come back and submit to him and let him lift you than for you to lift yourself. Because a king without God is not a kingdom. It's the dumb that makes a king to become a king. Look at somebody say, a king without dumb is not a kingdom. It's the dumb that makes a king to become a kingdom. Is this for you, eh? A king without what? Dumb. It's not a what? A kingdom. It's the tongue that makes a king to become a what? Which means when you lift yourself and the Lord has not put a crown on you, you will continue to carry your own chair, walking around, and nobody will call you a king. There was a time I went somewhere back home in Fantinu town. I said this here, now let me say, a certain foolishman called himself a king. I was going to buy carpet for the church back home, a red carpet, fronting it and I said, simply, the guy started cutting the hotel short. I look at the man, I said, Nana, which is king? I salute you. The guy look at, the guy that was selling the carpet look and left and right, said, foolish man, who is a king? Sir, he's not a king. I said, what are you talking about? The man's chair, big one, black and gold, and cloth, yellow canteen knives, and the kingship distinct, my God, and have all the, those things are here and here. I said, what did you just say? He said, he's not a king.
I said, thank you.
He made a whole thing for himself, and every afternoon, he will pack his car. And he will carry his own chair and put it there and sit, and people will be saluting. And night time, he will carry it himself. I look at the guy, I say, are you sure? He said, if you like, come here 5 o'clock. You see that Mercedes? Old Mercedes, I say, yeah. He said, belong to the man. No one will carry, he will carry with the clothes. There was a time, he carried it and the clothes and the whole thing. He has to put everything back. Those took me foolish man. I said, what? So he doesn't have anybody under him. He said, he has made himself. Okay. So if you want to lift yourself up, that is the same way you will be. Nobody will not salute you. You'll be saluting yourself. No one will call you a king. But when you wait until God's own approval and his own divine power in your life, church people will save you. Because the appointed time is something that is magic. Mordecai revealed the secret to
Esther,
his own what?
Niece.
This top secret, some people, may God forbid, and it will never. Now someone will plot evil against His Excellency President Obama, and you will have the secret and inform the FBI, and they will do investigation and find out that the whole thing was true. Hey, church, if you are on handle deportation, they will pardon you because of that word, that secret. I am telling you. Am I right? Am I right? And from Mordecai to reveal that secret, that some people wanted to kill the king. And after the secret, after he has revealed the secret, they sent him back to the security post. Hey. This is our trouble. Somebody say, which trouble? Church, look at me. You and I can never show the people the way whereby they will do it and prosper. But you yourself, when you try, you cannot prosper. That is not the will of God. We can never reveal such a secret and to remain the same. Something needs to be done. Somebody says, but he has to wait for the appointed time. I am coming. The enemy can cause the timing of God to pass by. It happened to Jeremiah. It happened to Daniel. God has said that his children, Israelites, will go into captivity for how many years? 70 years. But when the time occurred, the enemy wanted the tide to divert itself, but the prophet of God spotted it. He started praying and started remembering God. Are you not the one who said that your children will go on this? The time is deep. Now, God, you must stand upon this and do something. Because the exact time is now. The enemy wanted the time of God and to what? To pass by. Because God works according to time. Shout hallelujah. Church, we can never show the people the way and for them to do something and prosper, but you yourself, when you do that business, you cannot prosper. You can never receive or reveal such a secret and continue to still sit at the what? At the security gate. Church, that is not our portion. Shout hallelujah. Look at somebody and say, that is not our portion. Shout glory be to God. Church, guess what? Guess what? The appointed time that our King Ahasuerus has to lift us up is now.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
So many Christians always pray for promotion. Promotion. Lord, I need promotion. At times, excuse me to use this word, at times we pray out of the word of God. And praying out of the word of God, you will not receive anything. Your prayer must be based on the word of God.
Amen.
Your prayer must be based on the what? On the word of God. Shout hallelujah. There was a time a certain lady came to me, Mr. Emeto's place where I used to live. Man of God, I've heard about your name. Very, you can see the woman was rich and was shaking, holding back. I've heard about your name. I am a fiancé. Oh, this thing is not good. Please pray for me. Something needs to be done. Somebody introduce me. And two phones, one here, somebody introduce me. And another phone call came, another one. Pastor, please, excuse me. And he wrote it. I was sitting here in the studio, looking. The Lord said to me, that is not a husband. I said, okay. Daddy, thank you. I asked the woman, I said, madam, the man that you want me to pray for so that everything will be fine, is that your husband? Because the Lord is telling me that is not your husband. She looked at me, her countenance changed. Man of God, you know, we are dating right now. Of course, he is in a relationship now, but the whole thing is in the court. I said, okay, go ahead. So what happened? Oh, they have 10 children. He said he didn't love the wife in the whole thing. I said, madam, go home. Let them divorce first. And after that, you will come here. Because I cannot pray and to move somebody from her husband. That is not the word of God. Oh, man of God, you know, they say that you are very powerful. I said, hey, my God! So Angie heard it. He said, bro, what is going on? I said, no problem. I said, go! That is not the word of God.
Yes.
Later on, the woman told some people and said that the way the pastor dealt with her, and one of them came to the house and said, Pastor, may the Lord bless you. Do you know that all of us, we have given them this thing, advice to leave them alone? This woman said, I will vow heaven and earth to smash the man. And it's that woman who is causing that thing. I said it. That doesn't base upon the word of God. So if you are here, wants to smash somebody's wife or somebody's husband, when you bring that topic on my table, you will see the red colors of Angela. knowledge. Because it doesn't imply I can pray for you, I can use double anointed oil. It doesn't imply with the word of God. Shout hallelujah. I'm not giving you the right information. If I give you the right information, shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. So this is the same thing I am saying right now. For Mordecai to reveal such a secret, and for him to still remain at the what? At the gate. What went wrong? And look at this. Esther will be sitting in her car. Driver, security guys and everything. And her own uncle will open the door and salute. Do you think that was right?
No.
But that night, which is tonight,
amen.
And that night has already manifested. When the appointed time occurred, when the appointed time what? Okay. The king could not sleep that appointed time. The king could not sleep. Tonight, when we raise the topic, hey, and if you don't want to pray, don't disturb somebody. You just recite and look at your shoes, your shirts, and touch your hair. Me, I don't care. Tonight, prayer is individualistic. Because the appointed time must come. Whether men of God, women of God, a church member, I sat down with a pastor, a prophet, back home, a mighty prophet. Everybody that knows that man of God, I don't want to mention name, a man that those days used to use 30 days all night, 40 days all night, very wonderful man who started prophetic ministry long time ago. Pray for people, breakthroughs, buying houses, traveling, mighty things, greater things, but the man was still living in poverty. Let me tell you this. Leadership is by example.
Yes.
If as a prophet of God, preaching to you, pray for you, may God forbid that it will never happen. And I pray that the same thing. Because every time the members and my kind look up to the leadership. That is why when you become a leader, you have to be very careful about the way you make things. When something went go wrong in this place, people will mention Joe Biden, am I right? But Joe Biden's name will be just 10%. But 90% will go to His Excellency President Barack Obama. Because he is the father of the nation. Am I right?
Yes.
Right now, Nigerians, when you are talking good, Jonathan. Ghana, when you are talking, oh, Mahama. Am I right?
Yes.
You talk about the leader. Oh, things are not going well. Oh, look at this, they are stealing. People are doing this. Whereby in the system, people are doing it. Corruption, headmasters, electricity, police, they can stop you. You have everything all right. A friend of mine that there was a time a police officer stopped him. Where is your fire extinguisher? The guy provided a Christian. Didn't want to pay any bribe. Where is your first aid box? The guy, your brake light, pop, brake light. The left one, pop, the left one. Everything, officer finished. Allow me to go. The man said, but where is your cutlass? He said, which cutlass? He said, suppose you're the 3, 4. The man said, I've not heard such a thing before. He said, give me something, and go give me something. He said, I will not give you anything. Moving, starting from first aid box, brake light, everything. Now the officer is asking about it. So whether you like it or not, when they stop you, they will take something. And you too, you will give. So you are helping them to corrupt. Am I right? I was in my car. The one set up, a police officer stopped me. I parked by the side. I know some people, which as a pastor, I used to be there. Some connection. I can call one call. Officer, hey, leave him, Professor, and let him go. But I was standing, police officer, woman. He said, wait, I'm going to take you to office. I said, I'm waiting for you. Stopping the car. I said, madam, you say you are taking me. He said, wait. I said, what are you talking about? He looked at me and said, but you, where are you from? I said, I'm not from nowhere, but I'm going somewhere. He said, ah, so you don't understand the times? I said, which times? Because it's a DV or something, we have to be 2 passengers and 3. You want to take me to office? Let me go and pay it in the office. I cannot let you put it in your pocket. Shout hallelujah. I was standing there, I became furious. I said, where is your number, your badge? Let me see your badge number. I started, he said, hey, go, 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 go. Shout hallelujah. I don't know if I'm giving them right information. The leader. Look at somebody say and say the leader. Church, look at me. Tonight, your King Ahasuerus cannot sleep. Look at this. This man one time called somebody. Prepare assembly hall, Kumasi. The whole place was packed. Was about to pray for somebody. He closed his eyes and he saw himself, a prophet, himself in a basket. He was like a little boy and they have covered something like this. A basket that used to have the cover. He was inside and they have covered it. He opened his eye and closed it again. He was about to prophesy a good prophecy to someone. Closed his eye, saw himself, little boy. 3 times, he looked at the guy. He said, sir, you have been redeemed. You must go in peace. He announced the next day that the whole thing has been canceled. So next time he will try and do it again. He took a car straight to Enebehi in his village. Went to his uncle. Just one uncle left him. And said, uncle? It's okay. Okay. Uncle? Thank you. Uncle? What is going on? What is, you know, I want to know the things in this family. He said, sit down. Why? What brought you here? He said, I don't know, but I just want to know. He said, no man has ever prospered in this family. You see our family house, this, I think 3 or 4, this 4 or 3 bedrooms, the whole thing was half. He said, since you grew up to this day, have you seen anybody as a man that have built? He started casting his mind back. He said, there was a curse they released onto our side and started narrating everything. Was argument between his grandfather concerning somebody, and the person cursed his side, and it affected them generation upon generation. And he was a prophet, a pastor, all right, which is a title. For people to call you a pastor does not mean a pastor, automatically the curses will be destroyed in your family. It's just a title. Somebody is a lawyer. Somebody is a doctor. That's why we call somebody a pastor. That's why when some pastors fool, you cannot bring the good pastors among, because it's a title. He said, hey. He said, Jumo, from there, I took a passenger car straight to Atria Mountain, the mountain back home, 21 days. And radiate, which means, God, this is not my destiny. God, he has preached, prophesied for 17 years, but he was still swimming in poverty. The 18th year was the time he saw himself in the basket, but he was still delivering people. Who told you that when you become born again, automatically everything will be destroyed? You can be a born again, all right, and die in poverty, all right, and go to heaven, good. Because your poverty cannot prevent you not to go to heaven. And when you begin to pray to, you can, maybe you are lucky, your grandparents, they did not do anything, you are good. But me, they did something, you know. And I don't know about you. So if they didn't do anything, you must thank God. Shout hallelujah. Me, they did something that men, they used to finish them in my father's house. When I became born again, about so many years ago, I destroyed it. Amen. And I became free.
Amen.
Because I asked myself, I said, how can my father die so young at the age of 32? And God started revealing that secret. So I have to inquire. I have to go to the family house with oil. When I entered the place, I said, peace be to this house. All the witches and the red light, God, by God's grace, God cut out all of them. My Bible was on my armpit. I was holding on. I said, peace be to this house. Everybody say amen. They say amen. I said, hey, now we are talking. Shout hallelujah. Shout glory to God. My brother is here. My brother used to go there with father physical. I know that you came, my father. You today, all of you, and they'll be running. I call you and say, be careful. You don't fight these people with physical. At this time, shout hallelujah. I opened my oil, I started pouring it in the middle of the compound. I said, from today, that spirit, those curses have been destroyed. Because the time you killed that man, I was not in town, I was just a kid. But now, those things must stop.
Amen.
Pour the oil, we're not finished. I crush the bottle. I look at all of them. I say, everybody say amen, it has been destroyed. They by force, they say amen, it has been destroyed. I say, thank God. I went there with care, taxi. When I finish, I jump into my taxi. Since that time, up to today, just one person. Since that time, up to today, what? Just one person. And that one person even disobeyed. About 17 years now. No man. Was just one who disobeyed. I want him not to touch some food. Came to me and said that he touched that thing. Even him, about 9 years, no, 11 years ago. No man, and the Lord destroyed those things.
Amen.
Church, if you don't rise up and block it and destroy it, you can die and go, but it can still fight your next generation. But I would rather stand on the guard and fight so that my children shall be free. Now that we are sitting here enjoying the weather, enjoying the whole thing, we must know that our enjoyment today was somebody's pain. Was somebody's what?
Pay.
Somebody pay the price. That's why now you can go Washington DC, you'll be moving up and down the whole thing. The time, those days, that they restrain Rosa Parks and those people, am I right? Not to sit at the same distance with, am I right? They pay the price. Today you can go somewhere and you are buying something and somebody says, I want to see your supervisor. Look at you. I want to talk to the human resource, and you'll be standing there. You're enjoying someone. If it was those days, can you ask for supervisor? It means that some people pay the price.
Yes.
And tonight, we must pay the price by you and I destroying every demonic stronghold. Witches and witches, all the activities, their plans concerning our life. So tonight is a night of war. And let me tell you, some of you, when you stand and pray and are launched, you will see some things that will happen to you. The chains shall be broken, and you shall be free as a believer and serve God all right without any fear. Some families, you can see good women, but there will be no husband. Church, some families, you can see beautiful women, but their husbands will be like... You can look at the woman, is that the housewife or the husband or the husband? That is a real husband. That is how the enemy has made it. Church, let's be realistic. Shout hallelujah. This is not right. It's not right. After 21 days, he came down from the mountains. He was in his house. Somebody knocked the door. After the 21 days, came back. Four days, somebody knocked his door. Prophet, I just came from Germany. If you remember, you prayed for me about 7 years ago. I was with him in his room, was telling me all this thing. Not somebody told me. You prayed for me 7 years ago. The Lord has blessed me. I brought some white people from Germany. We have opened a company. If you have heard this company, you know. He said, yes. No knowing the man has become somebody in Accra. Have a big company, some things. But the one who prayed for him, and now that he has become somebody, he forgot about the person. Church is purely spiritual. At times you can pray for some people, you know, you can help some people. When it is time for you to, you know, lick a little bit liquor, they will run. In your life, you can be there for friends, you can be doing some things when they break through. And the person will run. Another person will come with poverty. You will help the person when the person break through, will run. Another person will come. Why? Wow, you have been restoring. This is the time. You too, you have to make something. Be on your feet. I'm speaking to you. From today onwards, you can. can never become like a signboard. People cannot see you as exit 19. Am I right? Going to, I don't know, new parents or something. Am I right? And you yourself cannot go to that place. He said, I was sitting in my office and your this thing came in my mind.
Jesus.
Prophet, forgive me. I've sinned against you. Oh, all these years. They step out. The prophet escorted him outside, gave him money. As soon as the man stepped, was about to open his car, Mercedes. He turned and looked at the man. Prophet, where is your car? Yeah, I don't have any car. Where I am right now is a rented place. I live in Sabah. The man said, what? Tomorrow morning, you'll hear from me. The next morning, Mercedes Benz from Accra to his place in front of his house with the key, with the driver, and say that August said I should give him this. Somebody that he prayed for also came back. God, drop your this thing in my mind. I've been thinking about you. Man of God, do you remember you prophesied in my life? I can't remember that nation, so I don't want to lie. Oh God, I've seen a bit. Is that your living room? He said, yes, I'm living. No. Can you ask about the land in this place? I want to bid for you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
The time I was talking to him in his room, God has blessed him 7 houses. And he started giving car keys to his pastors. And now, him and poverty, there is a restraining order. Between you and poverty, there must be a restraining order. When he was saying it, tears, he started weeping. He said, this is me. This is me today. I look at him, listening, I say, this is a mystery. The generational curse fought him upon all his title. And then you can see some people when they are coming, lift their shoulder, Reverend Haya, Reverend Moose, something, something, will be coming like this. Church, poverty has nothing to do with your Moose. I would rather remain simple and deal with poverty. They're big names. Carry big names, but they are still suffering. Look at somebody and say, it's not a joke. Shout hallelujah. Look at somebody and say, it's not a joke. Some of you can help some friends. Help them when they break through. You'll never hear from them anymore. And by the time you realize another one who needs help will come, you will help and help. The person will check. It's not normal. It's not normal.
It's an error.
More than error. Everybody shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. I tell you, there will be some family, powerful women, that when you see some women, you cannot even look at them. Two. Am I right? Excuse me. Forgive me. At a time, some families, the woman that you see cannot even stand those, am I right? You know, some this thing, but men will be begging them, running after, hey! Remember the good faces. Men will not go, but the other ones. Look at somebody and say, it's not right. Something needs to be done. This is what I am talking about. Adam, the woman, you know something that I'm talking about. We say that, I don't like it. I don't want you. I want you to go. The man will be begging, oh, please. Whoever nice, even will like this one to come and even pamper him, but no one will come. Hey! Something. I said, something needs to be done. Do you have the whole picture?
Yes.
Now lift up your hands. Then the whole thing is in your hands. If you want to joke with your prayer tonight, you joke with it. Young boy, how are you? Yeah. Who brought you here?
I came myself.
You came yourself. Let's see. Maybe after prayer, let's see what the Lord will do. Shout hallelujah. Everybody call up and lift up your two hands. Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Father, tonight.
Father, tonight.
Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Tonight. Father.
May you
take me
from my doorpost.
My security room.
Into the palace.
Because I deserve it.
And the whole night came, Ahasuerus put in what? Sleep.
He opted for the book of Chronicles, not the book of Chronicles in the Bible. The whole book of the kingdom. They started reading it. Number one, the king was powerful. Oh, king, may you live forever. This is the history of the whole thing. I don't know. Maybe when they read 10 or 5, because the Bible was silent, and they started, there was a time, a man called Mordecai. Hey, so are you trying to tell me the king always go out in? So are you trying to tell me that the king didn't know the name of Mordecai? And married even Liz. Didn't know Mordecai. And are you trying to tell me that Esther didn't tell the king that it's Mordecai who revealed that secret? And after everything, they thank him and said, I go back to your post and work. But that night, heaven made some meeting. Holy Ghost, Jesus, and Christ God. And Holy Ghost said, this one is an error. Daddy, this man cannot remain like remain the same. No. Daddy, something needs to be done. He said, now what do you want us to do? He said, Holy Ghost said, let me go and arrest the king. And Holy Ghost arrested him. Some of us, at times, Holy Ghost can arrest you, which you cannot sleep. Some of you, at times, you can't sleep, you go and take your sleeping tablet. You are sick. I beg you in the name of God. At times, if you can't sleep, it means that God wants you to do some specific assignment. You must discern. You may lay yourself on the bed, you will not feel. Sit. Put your pillow somewhere.
Hallelujah.
Maybe there is something going on the Lord wants you to intercept. I'm not saying that you can't sleep, but at times it can be something, and at times it can be, you know, some days you cannot, you feel that there is something I have to do.
Yes.
You must pray.
Amen.
Holy Ghost arrested him. Upon all the sleeping tablets and everything, the king could not sleep. Holy Ghost held the eyebrows and everything, shout hallelujah, and could not sleep. And the king said, now bring me the book. There was a time a man called Mordecai revealed some secret in the whole thing. You know, those people that wanted to assassinate him and the whole thing. And Mordecai revealed the secret, those people, they hung them. And the king said, hey, I want you to pause over there. That person, what have they done to that person? They said, nothing. Mordecai, the one sitting on the doorpost. He said, what? So are you trying to tell me that the king didn't know? But Holy Ghost directed him and they brought the book. And Holy Ghost divine connection prompted the king. And the king said, what have you done to that person? He said, nothing. He said, hey, okay. Shout hallelujah. And the pose and the clothes and everything that Naaman they gave unto him at the end of the day became his. Church, there are some people walking there. They are wearing your clothes, your shoes, walking around until you cry to God. There will be no excuse. And I believe 100% that Mordecai used to cry before God. It's not everything that appeared in the Bible. Father, upon all these secrets, I am still sitting on the post. I know that you will speak. I know that you will do this. I know that you will do that. Lord, upon all this, Lord, I know that you will do something. And that day, today, may the Spirit called Holy Spirit,
amen,
who is a person,
amen,
arrest your Mordecai.
Yes.
And by tomorrow morning,
amen,
may them remember you.
Amen.
A certain man, Ms. Vivian knows that man, I pray for. Yes, so many years ago. Walking in his place, those days, bush, sinners and some kings, walking, praise the Lord, in the name of Jesus, anointed the place in the hotel, the man became someone, and they don't remember me. Then, shout hallelujah, used to come to the house, sit there, prayer, revelation, direction, amen, breakthrough king, they didn't remember me. I lift up my hands one day and say, Father, this is not right.
Yeah.
Shout hallelujah. I said, this is not what? This is not right. In Africa, shout hallelujah. Church, that night, I declare unto him, I say, Lord, let the Holy Ghost arrest him and let him remember me. The next day he called me, Odi, where are you? I am here. He dropped $10,000 in my pocket. I'll remember you. That was the way. I will continue. But if I didn't know the reason why, oh, I've sinned against you. This is $10,000. And he started. No. Look at somebody and say, you have no idea. I stood on my feet. Oh. I said, Father, this is not right. Heaven must speak on my behalf.
Yes.
Ah! And can you see? He started blessing some people, building some things for people, doing something. And me, that I prophesied, you know, until he became somebody. They didn't remember me. I said, my God, not me.
Yes.
Holy Ghost arrest him.
Yes.
And I believe that something happened. And the next day, I saw the phone listener. I said, now you are talking. Cry as I'm home. Shout hallelujah. Or someone to go somewhere. But I changed my mind. Well, I didn't want him to go anywhere, you know, to come to my place and go back. Hey, when he goes and give it to someone, what am I going to say? I said, I'm at home. I said, I'm coming right now. Shout hallelujah. Why every pa in Africa, American money? Is that we pay him for this thing? I say, then now you are talking. Leave that and let me bless you. I took my oil. Amen. I receive it. The other man that know, you know, something came on my head. I said, hey, glory be to God. Will the Lord continue to remember you? To someone, this is what the man is talking about. Look at someone and say, hey. connect somebody to your own workplace, and at the end of the day, you will be fired. But what have you done wrong? As a child of God, church, there is something that we must deal with. It. I am done. I will not talk anymore. Now let's take your two hands. I would like you to position yourself. You can move from your chair. The pastors will pick the mic. Church, and those who are watching all over the world, may the Lord today, by His own divine power, remember you. Shout hallelujah. We are going to pray this prayer, and by the power of God, and by the mighty hand of God, may the Lord remember you and I, and do greater things in our life, because things must change. Look at somebody and say, things must change. And tomorrow, what did I just say? Tomorrow morning, those people will pack and go. Witches will pack and go. Wizards will feel uncomfortable. Hypocriticals, sinners, and those who turn into sinners, doubts, and the whole thing, Holy Ghost fire will crush them. And somebody that you have done something good will remember you and look for your number. Expect unexpected call. Expect breakthroughs. Shout hallelujah. You can never come to this place and be a failure. Say in the name of Jesus.